Right, guys, had two packages through today. Been waiting for a long time to get my hands on a pair of these. These are the latest versions from Pioneer's CDJ 2000 range. These are the CDJ 2000 Nexus 2s. I bought a pair of them. I've saved up for 10 months to buy these. My dream's to do music and make music, and I'm just starting out. This is my YouTube channel. I've already done a review for the XLR cable from Pioneer. Gonna do a unboxing for the next one probably next month. I can't afford to buy that cable this month because I spent like nearly 3.5 grand on these, so they're not cheap, and they are their beast. But anyway, I've been waiting for like 10 months to buy a pair. I was initially gonna buy the Nexuses, but as I came close to accumulating the rest of the funds I needed, I had a gutsy feeling they were going to announce the Nexus 2s, and I was right, and I'm so happy that I decided to wait the extra couple of months. But yeah, I mean, I'm so happy that I've waited because I've got the latest stuff. They probably won't announce the next ones on from these. I can't see them doing a Nexus 3. Because like with the CDJ 1000, they went to the Mark III as far as I know. So this is the third version of the 2000 range. So I pretty much 100% sure that they go to the CDJ 3000 or 2900 for like the one down below that, or that's the only option they've got really on from this CD deck. If I decide to keep the CD bay going on their top of the line decks that they make. As you see, they've got XDJ models out now. They'll probably make an XDJ 2000 eventually. I can also see like a Remix 2000 coming along eventually, an effects modulator update on their end as well, I reckon. And hopefully we'll have these matching up with a DJM 2000 Nexus 2 also when they announce that. I reckon they didn't announce the DJM 2000 Nexus 2 because obviously they want to make sales on the DJM 900 Nexus 2s first and bring them into clubs first before they bring out the highest ended mixer that they have, which is the 2000 range, along with these. Now, if they don't do the DJM 2000 Nexus 2, then it would be wrong because you can't have the 2000 decks without a 2000 mixer. If you want a complete setup, that is a complete setup. I understand a 900 for the club because it's smaller and it's made specifically for like for all a DJ would need in a club. But I would like the extra stuff in that from the 2000, with like being able to do like recording and using it in a studio and stuff, just add extra to like your studio, like recordings and that. So with me, I do want the professional top-ended mixer, so I'm hoping they do announce that. But anyway, this is going to be the unboxing for the CDJ 2000 Nexus 2s. I have two of them, so let me get rid of the first box because I'm only going to unbox one. But I'll show you, well, I'll unbox both, but obviously out of this box, but I'm only going to be fully unboxing one of the players, so I'll show you the other one. But yeah, so yeah, good old knife. Got to use your knife, right? So yeah, straight down there. So this is coming straight out of the box, so obviously. So yeah, so next month I'm hoping to get the digital coax lead from Pioneer. I'm gonna get two of them. As you see, I buy my equipment from Backstore, Backshop. I buy my equipment from, not Box Backstore. But yeah, right. We've opened that box. So yeah, stick this here. So yeah, as usual, they are well packaged their products, which I really like about the back shop. That they're really well packaged, as you can see. So you got this styrofoam, like, puffed up bags that really protect your gear very well. So yeah, and then it looks like they've also included some cables. Where are we? General information that they include with it and stuff. That this is in case you have any problems with the products, that you can send them back and that, and you've got your, you get 3-year warranty with BAX as well. Most retailers only do 1 and 2 year warranties, but with BAX they do 3 years included. So I don't know why they've put kettle plugs in with these boxes, because with what I've seen of unboxing of these new players, they have both the European plug and the UK plug inside each box. So looks like they've given me some extra kettle plugs. So that's a bonus, I suppose. Might come in handy one day. As usual, you get a back sticker. So that's my fourth one I've got now. So yeah, there it is. There's the first one. The first CD player, a CDJ 2000 Nexus 2. Multiplayer, it plays SD cards, CDs, USB sticks, and it can run by HID mode and all that. Yeah, so basically these are the newest players, and that they output FLAC, WAV, AIFF, which is a lossless audio files, as far as I know, from all that range of 24-bit at 96 kilohertz that the DeX can output to a mixer. So yeah, I mean, these are really freaking good. There is some more packaging, some more down the sides, and there's some at the bottom too. So yeah, here it comes, here we go. And this is the best way of doing it, I suppose. Get rid of that quickly. So yeah, there's one side of it. Right. And then you're in the other side of it. Another side of the player. And then another side of the player. Now, this is going to be basically a very detailed unboxing. I'm not going to go over all the functions that the player does, because I'm new at starting out with DJing, and also we'll be getting into studio production, home studio production. I'm building up for that. I've been building up for that for a while. But yeah, that's the sides of it, the top of it, and what's in the bottom? Nothing on the bottom, it's just a white. Just a white bottom to it, so there's nothing to it, so yeah. Now yeah, so yeah, as it says, multi-format audio player for professional DJs, FLAC, ALAC, WAV, IFFF, MP3, AAC, and CD quad audio. So yeah, it does it all. Digital features, beat sync, wave zoom, quantized looping, high quality DSP, digital sound processing, high resolution audio playback. So yeah, as I said, 24-bit, 96 kilohertz, that can go through the three audio files there. The FLAC, ALAC, and WAV are the high audio, I guess, at the 24-bit, 96 kilohertz up to range. So yeah, you got full colour display and touch panel. Yeah, that's the new thing. The reason why I wanted to wait was because of the touch screen. I knew the XDJ 1000s came out, then the XDJ 700 came out, and I mean, they're pro players, the Nexus, right? That they were brilliant anyway, but I mean, with that, with a touch screen on them, wow, you know what I mean? That just boom, you know what I mean? That's just gonna make searching your tracks and that a lot more quicker than using the old dial. I mean, I've never had any of these decks before, but I've seen videos and stuff, and using that dial on there just to search for your tracks takes quite a bit longer. So being able to like QWERTY search, like bang, 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 you know what I mean? You just think of something, bang it in. And then yeah, it comes up, you sing it over and bang, you're away. So yeah, this guy hid. So yeah, I was only gonna take one of these out from the box. So the other one is in there. I'll probably show you that in a minute, but yeah, just to prove that I have two. Well, I do have two. So yeah, I'll try not to ruin the box if I can. Yeah, right. Oh my god. So this is the time. Let's get some of this away quick. I need to make some room for the other one. There, yeah. I'm down there. Notice I'm only using my camera at the moment for unboxings, but if this YouTube channel of mine takes off, then I shall be buying some action cameras and that, and upgrading the resolution to 4K. At the moment, my channel is just going to be unboxings and stuff, but within a year time, I'm hoping to do performance videos and might even be able to do some guides on studio production too. And further unboxings to come, I guess. As I said, I've got to do two more videos for the cables and that from Pioneer, because obviously I noticed online there was only one unboxing, and that was the XLR. I've done that one myself, and I'm doing a series of unboxing. The next one that's coming is a digital coax cable from them. I'm buying two of them. So yes, but yeah, I've pierced the box, as you see. I'm just going to show you the other one before I get into that and have a look at it. They are quite a considerable weight, so, but I mean, for how much you pay for them, you don't want them to be flimsy and freaking plastic. You want them to be well built, so these should be quite well built. For the price of, and what I've seen of them, they look very well built, like metal plates and stuff like that on them. I've heard they've got scratch resistant coating on that one, on the actual top plate of the deck. So yeah, we're all good. So this is the other one. See, I'm not gonna actually take this out. I'll just show it to you because that's the one I'm actually gonna unbox over there. So yeah, there's the other player. So yeah, that's all I'm gonna show for now. So this one can go back over there now. So I have two of them. Two lovely, lovely players. Now let's bring this one back over that I've pierced and opened. Rightio, let's continue. Right, so this is the actual part now where I'm about to take these babies out of their box. So yeah, this is a big day for me. I mean, I've been waiting years to get these. As I said, like, they included the included two more extra cables for me. Not that I need them, because there's your European plug, the two-pronged European plug to get all these. So yeah, there's that. And then maybe not. I thought they included them, so. Obviously, they've come from Europe, I guess, these players, but they should still be working on the right power. So I don't think that it's got all the information on that one in English as well. So I don't have no worries that they won't work on the electric in the UK. I don't know. I've never owned any of these players in that, or anything that runs on different sorts of powers, you know. So I don't know, this is the first unboxing. So anyway, this is I opened it up, but yeah, you get a information packet, you get your RCA leads. Looks like they're only silver plated. I thought they might have been gold by the video reviews and that. I swear they look like they were gold, but they're actually not. They're only silver plated. And you get a Ethernet cable too, Cat 5 E, I think it is 5E. You get Cat 5E cable with it. So yeah, they give you everything to start out with. I'm not going to be unsealing these because I want to keep these sealed in case I ever want to resell them, if I want to upgrade to the next ones up from these. I won't be upgrading unless I get anywhere with my music. So if I get anywhere making music, start to make an income from that, then yeah, I'll do more unboxings and keep progressing my YouTube channel. And then yeah, but that's why I'm not going to be unpacking that and showing you through this. But yeah, I mean, you can get all this information from their website anyway, so that's where I'll be going if I need to look through any of the information I need. So yeah, they only included the one. I thought they included both in the player, but they didn't. So I'm guessing those unboxes you've seen on YouTube are the ones for the reviewers, obviously. So Pioneer have included review type decks that they expect to go back to them eventually. Unless, I guess, you do a good review and then Pioneer are nice and let you have them. But for $1.699 a deck, highly doubt that unless you've done a really good review and it's got a lot of views that you'll be able to keep it. So yeah, I'm just going to put it down on the floor now and then I'm going to bring it back up on the table. Yeah, right, get a good hand for it. And here it comes. I'll get a good grip of it, right, okay. So yeah, no more stuff in the box. Box can go over here. And then so can the other bits. I'm going to lean it up on its side here just for a second so I can get a good... Righty, okay. So the unveiling of the deck. And then, yeah. And then I got the other one. Chuck that styrofoam down there for the protection. Gently put the deck down. So yeah, this is the stuff they wrap it in, whatever it is, I don't know. It's just, yeah. Even through the star, even through the thing, you can see the Pioneer logo. So yeah, and here we go. Oh, that brand new smell is lovely. I never get enough of that when I get new unboxing. When you unbox something new, I had that with the PlayStation 3. You'll remember that when I undone it. And then yeah, I mean, to get that off later. There's a little bit of a sellotape there that didn't come off when I peeled it back. That one did though. So yeah, I have to get that off later. Yep, here we go. Here it comes. Oh, that is such a nice smell. Brand new. So nice. Ready? Here we go. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. That is so sleek. So sleek, man. Eventually I'm gonna opt to buy protection for the top of it. I'm gonna get deck savers and that, but as far as I know, they haven't announced any yet or put any on the website, so as soon as they put some on the website, I'll go and buy two of them. I'm going to be hooking these up to my DDM 4000 mixer for now, until hopefully by about November I have enough saved to buy the mixer when it gets announced, the DJ M2000 Nexus 2, to accompany these. So, wow, it's freaking heavy. It is a real beast of a piece of equipment. And as you can see on the back of it, it's got some Japanese stuff on it, as you see. Pioneer DJ CDJ 2000 Nexus 2. Designed by Pioneer in Japan. And then yeah, you got your link, your digital out, and your audio out as well. So via RCA and that, which I'm connecting to my DDM 4000 at the minute, when I get my new deck, my new mixer I need, I'll be connected straight up via digital. So yeah, and should be able to output high end sound. So yeah, as you can see, you've got everything on it. I was going to put it down, demonstrate it, but I'll hold it up. You got loads on it. I'm not not going to go through it all because I'm still new at all this, so I don't know what it all does. I mean, I've obviously looked at lots of videos before I bought these to get an idea, but I'm not going to talk about it in case I say something wrong. Yeah, anyway, this was just meant to be a detailed unboxing and a detailed look of the unit. So yeah, it's freaking heavy, but oh well. You got your slot load there for your CDs and stuff. And then underneath the deck, you've got a key there, a little key there, to force eject the disc if it ever gets stuck. With that little hole there, you can input it from there. Underneath from there, you've got some more information, your serial number and all that shit. I swore, oops. Wouldn't be me if it wasn't me. These feet are quite smart. They got like chrome, they're plastic. They look plastic here, but the feet in that, they got a bit of rub. I don't know if that's, no, that's plastic. I thought that might have been a bit of rubber there, but no, they're plastic. Oh well. Underneath from that, that's metal chassis, obviously. A bit of plastic around here, plastic up there. But then that top plate, oh, I'm tapping them, maybe shouldn't be doing that. But no, it should be fine. You got a USB also input, I didn't, you know what I mean? So you got your power button, your power on button. You got your power on button at the far left hand side. Then your RCA audio outlet, right, red, left, white. Then you got a single digital out to obviously your digitals on your mixer. If you've got digital capability, I suggest using digital because it fires over the stream of files much better to your mixer than an RCA would, because it's just a much more solid stream. And then obviously you go out from your mixer to your amp or speaker system that can utilize the digital out, because it will make the sound better, a lot better. But anyway, you've got your link cable, and you get your cable in with the deck, and then you've got USB as well. USB, they don't include a USB lead within the packet, so if you need one of them, if you want to go buy a HID mode, I think it's called, into your whatever software you want to use. And as far as I know, I don't think these decks at the moment utilises HID mode via Serato and Traktor. I think it's just Record Box I don't think Record Box do HID mode at the minute. So yeah, you've got your pitch slider here and all that, your tempo, whatever it is, tempo slider and stuff. Noticing in the middle on that, with what I hear, they used to have a little bit of a lock bit at the top, but these don't. It's just a smooth flow from top to bottom. So the middle and that, it don't try to stop you, sort of thing. And you've got all the other buttons and that does everything else. You've got your master tempo, plus 6, plus 10, plus 16, then slash wide. And that, you've got your beat sync area, instant doubles and that. So you sync and master. Now I reckon sync and that is only okay, in my point of view, if you're doing mashups and like, if you're performing within it. So say if you've got like a MIDI keyboard plugged into your like mixer, and you're doing a mobile performance while you're using these decks to play tracks out, then in my point of view, that is okay. But if you're just doing it because you want to be lazy and stuff, then that's just wrong, in my point of view. But yeah, that's my own point of view. I mean, do what you want, but you know what I mean? Some people won't appreciate that if they're in that area the same as you know what I mean, of music. So, you know what I mean? I started when I was in college and that. I did music tech for about 2 years. I was going to do a third year. I was doing a national when I dropped out of that because I had issues and stuff. And the other issue was that I didn't have the gear in that, and I didn't really want to succeed without it, to be fair. I was taking knowledge in that I needed. Yeah, it was good. The knowledge I did take in, I've kept in my head what I feel like I needed. I wish I did take in a lot more while I was at college. I do regret it slightly, but then I don't, because I didn't have the gear like I'm getting now. You know what I mean? I had to get a job to get the gear. It's the only way it's going to be done. So that's what sort of swayed me off from college. And if I had all this gear before I went to college, which some families are way off to begin with, well, I'm not. So, you know what I mean? I've had it rough until I got a job, got the job, decided I wanted that, stuck to it, and here you go. You know, I've achieved it. Finally achieved the hardest part of the gear. Right? I'm looking to buy a pair of vinyl decks eventually, to accompany two of these. So I've got CDN and vinyl, but it's not a priority right now. I want to get the mixer next to connect up to it to give that sound quality. So yeah. But yeah, you should only use these if you're live performing in your tracks basically, or as I said, if you're mashupping, if you're like putting multiple tracks in one, which you would only really do if you're using more than two decks anyway. Really, you can mash up with two, but three decks is more right. You know what I mean? I mean, if I could afford it, I would have bought a third deck, but it costs so much money. So this will probably be the only two I get. This will be the only two I get unless I get anywhere. And then if I announce the next one, which I reckon will be probably be at the start of 2020, I reckon. Yeah, 16. Maybe 2019, the next deck will be announced by Pioneer. But it might not necessarily have the CD deck, the CD bay. With my point of view, I think they should keep it going, because people don't like CDs now because everything's like on like very portable, like little tiny freaking SD cards and USB sticks and that, or you use your computer in that. But to be fair, like having a CD in that, you from where you're getting the files and that online, they're still slightly compressed. So having a CD and stuff, yeah, where they've been bounced off and that from the original artists and stuff, and then later mass produced onto CD and stuff, you probably get slightly better quality in using singles and stuff. I've got like freaking all like I've got singles and stuff in this drawer here, but that I'm going to be using. I'm going to be still using the CD. I tend to collect all like the classics and stuff on CD because I like quality of sound. So, and I've got a really expensive sound setup. I've spent a lot on that. Spent about like 1.5, I think, now, including my cables connected up to it. And you can't buy the SDJ-08 monitors now from Pioneer because they discontinued them. I managed to get them actually like at the last stage of them being out. I thought I wasn't going to be able to get them, but then I got lucky. I did research online. I was worried that I wouldn't be able to get them because they had been discontinued, and I was just lucky that this shop that I managed to track down in the end had one last pair. So, you know what I mean? I bought their last pair in the whole of the UK and probably the whole of the world, you know, and oh, I love them. They're the pride and joy. These now will probably become my pride and joy, obviously. You know. But anyway, as soon as the deck covers come out for these, I'm going to buy a pair of them because I've got to keep these in mint condition as possible. Because I might, as I said, if I don't get out with my music, I'm never going to give up my hobby. This is my hobby. But if I can't get out there with making money from it, although money to me is not really the big thing, making music, caring for the music and caring for overall the world, I just love to help. That's what I want to do. I want to help the world as much as I can, because I feel like the world needs it. You know, you hear all these wars non-stop. Well, what's the point? War just is money. That's all it is. It's all government want is money, yeah. But with music and that, it brings people together. You know, it has that sort of heart to it, that you feel that, hang on, why should there be wars? It makes you think. Music makes you think and come together that there shouldn't be any of that around. There should be no war, peace, love, tranquility, and good music. But either way, this was my unboxing for the CDJ 2000 Nexus 2. I've bought two of them. They're going to be connected up to my DDM 4000 from Behringer until about November, when I'm hoping they announce the DJM 2000 Nexus 2. So then I can go in from them and have a complete setup. So until then, this was my unboxing, as I see.